Hey guys, it's Sim Queen, and today I'm doing another build for my save file. This is my fifth build, or I guess fifth house, basically. One renovation, and now this is the fourth build. And so I pretty much finished now this little area of Willow Creek where most of the starter homes are. I don't know what to call it, but I'm considering it like the first sort of neighborhood of Willow Creek that is done. So this house is on a weird lot. Every time I've ever built on this house, I've done it sort of lengthwise. So if the house is like rotated 180 degrees facing the street, like facing the same way as the neighboring houses. But when you go to put the house on the gallery, it takes a screenshot from the front of the house, like from this angle here. So I feel like I've always been building it the wrong way. So I really wanted to make sure I did it right this time. And so I built it front facing, which I think it felt a little weird, but especially for the backyard, like the whole back area feels a little bit off to me. But I still like the way it turned out. I'm really happy with the outside of it. I was going for that sort of New Orleans theme, and it ended up being a little bit more of a colonial theme. I haven't decided what I'm going to call this build yet. I was thinking small colonial house or something like that, because yeah, it got that New Orleans theme got away from me just a little bit. But I'm still really happy with how it turned out. I still think it suits the neighborhood really nicely. I don't want them all to be the same style exactly and the same colors. It gets a little bit boring. So speaking of boring, I'm trying to make the house more interesting by putting all these like bump outs and different things around the house. But yeah, so it's a bigger house in this neighborhood. It's actually ended up costing, it's worth 120,000 simoleons, which is pretty expensive for this area, but I think they have some nicer stuff in this home. It's three bedrooms. It's got a laundry room, two bathrooms, and a bit of like, I guess it's more open concept for the living area. But yeah, I think it turned out really nicely, and it's definitely a house I could see myself playing in. The floor plan, of course, was a bit of a struggle. It always is. I really wanted to make it three bedrooms and two bathrooms, just because all the houses I've been building so far have been like less than two bedrooms, like two or less. So yeah, I wanted to have something a little bit bigger. There is a family, sorry, that's my dog in the background. There is a family that lives in this house. It's a younger married couple. I don't have names for them yet, but the wife is, they're both young adults. They're both fairly young. The wife is a musician. She loves to play music. She plays all kinds of instruments. She does, I think, guitar, violin, and piano. So I did do like a little music room for her. And she does work in the music industry as well. And I think she is at that stage where she can like write jingles. I think it's called Jingle Jammer. I forget what it is, but that's kind of like where she's at in her career. So she's not super high up there, but she does okay. It's more of a hobby anyway. I think she more aspires to be a stay-at-home mom and just kind of do music as her own little hobby in the meantime. And then her husband is in the law career, so I'm not sure exactly where he's at with that. I haven't really decided, but pretty far in, because they do have a really expensive house. So I imagine he does have a degree. He went to university, so he was able to get a bit ahead in his career. And that's why they have like kind of a more expensive house for a younger couple. And they also, he likes to fish. So that's why they live by the creek. So he has the outdoor, loves the outdoor trait. So yeah, he can go fishing and kind of be a little bit outdoorsy as well. And they are expecting a daughter as well, so I put in a nursery for a little girl, which I think turned out really cute. So yeah, I don't really have any like names for them yet, first name or last, I'm not sure. They don't have any pets either. I think they just probably feel like they don't have enough time with their careers and like a baby on the way, so they don't have any pets in this household. Although most of the households that I build will have pets, just because I love including them. So this kitchen area, the inside and outside was inspired by a house that I found on Pinterest. I pretty much copied the outside, the front outside, like the sides and the back I can never get right, but the outside, the front of the house is pretty much copied from this picture I found on Pinterest. And then the inside floor plan is pretty close to the one, this same house as well. I love finding like house layouts and floor plans and copying them in The Sims. I find it so satisfying, and it makes it easier too, because I find that I'm a little bit closed-minded when it comes to floor plans. Like, I watch other people do speed builds and I'm like, how did you even think of that? Like, I don't know, I'm not great with floor plans. I tend to do the same thing all the time and I really want to get out of doing that. So I find that looking at different floor plans online of actual houses is sort of helpful to me. So I've been doing that a lot lately. But yeah, this one is quite open and I love those, like that white brick in the kitchen. I think it looks really nice. I didn't want there to be too much color in this house. I was kind of going for like elegant, like modern elegance, I guess. I don't even really know. I know nothing about interior design. I really don't. I just know what kind of looks good. But I don't know what you would call this exactly, but I do like the way that it turned out. I love those upholstered chairs. I think they look super nice. But yeah, that's like a little dining area. It's not a super big house, but all the rooms are spacious enough. I think the bedrooms are pretty good size, especially the nursery. That turns out to be my favorite one, I think. But yeah, so I didn't clutter this house up too much. Sometimes I clutter things up too much on purpose, but this one I really wanted to keep it, I don't know. I feel like the woman that lives here would look at a lot of different, like, design magazines, and she would really care about what her house looked like. And yeah, I just kind of went with that theme, like the idea of trying to keep up with the trends and make your house look as trendy as possible. I think that's something she'd be into. I originally wanted to put the bookshelves on either side of the fireplace, but they just weren't really looking that good, so I did get rid of those. And yeah, I made like a little living area. Normally I have the couch face the TV, but I tried something a little bit different this time, and I think it actually ended up looking a lot better. So yeah, I'm really pleased with the way that looked. I've been doing a lot of builds lately just because I haven't had a ton of time for recording and for doing voiceovers because people are always home. It's getting a little bit frustrating. I wish I had more alone time. But yeah, so I've been doing a ton of building because that's what I do when people are home and I want to play The Sims, but I can't talk to myself. So I just get in my game and build. So I think I had like 2 speed builds in a row come out last week. And then I have 2 this week again, I think. I've just been building a lot. Cause yeah, not a lot of time for recording. Voiceovers are easier because if someone even leaves for like 15 minutes, I can quickly bang out a voiceover. But for an actual episode, I need like at least 30 minutes to do that. So yeah, this is, it's going a lot better. And, I feel like I'm on a bit of a time crunch too. I always say this like constantly. But yeah, I haven't had much time to do anything Sims related. And now I actually have like 2 days to do 15 videos. So it's been really crazy. And then my husband and I were planning on going to Disneyland again. I went this time last year. I think last year we went January 20th to 25th, I think, if I remember correctly. But yeah, but now I'm thinking, I was just going to book our trip a couple of days ago. And I'm recording this like on January 4th, I think. I was just about to book the trip, and then this whole thing with like, I don't even want to get into it, but the whole Trump thing happened. And I just don't feel like traveling to the States is safe anymore, and it really is a huge bummer. And I don't want to like make this about, oh, like Trump ruined my Disneyland trip. That's not at all what I'm saying, but it does suck because I think it has changed our plans a little bit, and I know that we're probably like the least affected by this. People are much more affected by what's going on than just the spoiled brats who don't get to go on their vacations. But I am disappointed about it. And I think that I deserve to just have a little bit of sadness about that. Because yeah, I was about to book it for February 3rd or 4th or something like that. Early February, we're going to go to Disneyland. And because we just loved it last time. Like, we were obsessed with it. It was the first time my husband had ever gone. And it was the second time for me, but I was 8 the first time, so I didn't remember anything. And now it's all I think about. Like, I'm a Disney freak. It's disgusting. And yeah, I've just been planning this trip and we are so excited to go, and now we're thinking maybe we should hold off. It just doesn't feel safe to be even like traveling, not just going to the States, but traveling at all. It just doesn't feel that safe to me right now. So that's a bit of a bummer. Maybe I'm being dramatic. I don't know, but I would still love to be able to go. I do hope things calm down a little bit or something good happens. Some kind of like conflict resolution would be great. A peaceful conflict resolution would be amazing. Because yeah, these things, they give me a lot of anxiety. They really do. I don't like negative things happening in the world, and I don't want to talk about them that much either. So I'm going to move on from it. But yeah, hoping that we will still be able to go on our trip, and it's not going to be completely canceled, but we will see. I am going to Vegas in March as well. That is not booked either, but it's like my whole family going, so I do feel a little bit safer about that. But that plan might change too. I'm not sure, but either way, that's what's on my mind lately. Normally I like to talk about what's on my mind in my builds, and today that is what's on my mind. It's like just all the bad things going on in the world, and it's really rough. It honestly is. And I, as someone who suffers from anxiety, just like a lot of people, I do find that The Sims is a really good escape. And I've heard so many people say about like gamers and simmers actually in general, that a lot of us suffer from anxiety and depression and mental illnesses because all we do is spend our time playing video games. And I don't agree with that. I do agree that like it makes it worse by escaping into these little virtual reality worlds, but for me it really is an escape. I can just sit, and whether I'm building or playing, it doesn't matter. I can totally escape whatever's going on, and I can get complete control over what's happening in my game, and it's very peaceful and relaxing. It's like therapy. It really is. And I know that a lot of people think that that's silly, but I think just whatever works for you. Like if playing the game for an hour can give you an hour of peace and relief from anxiety or depression, then that is totally worth playing, I think, and totally worth putting your money into. So for me, that's what I've been doing a lot lately, is just jumping into my build whenever I feel anxious about things like this or worried about what's going to happen. I just jump into my game, and I remember that this game is always going to be there for me. I'm always going to be able to play, and you know, I'm always going to be able to control what happens. And there's nothing bad in this game. Like there's no war, there's no depression in this game either. There's no mental illness. I know those things are all realistic, but I don't have to worry about those things. And that to me is like a huge, huge relief. So I feel like I'm rambling about that a little bit, but I'm mostly just saying this so that you guys can relate to it, because that's totally what this game is about, is just doing something happy and exciting for a little bit. And that is what I use this game for. And if you do it too, I think that's a positive thing, and it's not a waste of time. It's not silly. It's totally valid to just get away for a little bit. But yeah, anyway, back to the build. So that was the music room I was just putting together there. I even put like a little music award on the shelf too. I put like a piano in there and a whole bunch of musical instruments that she can play. Not a lot for the husband though. I think I put the laptop in there so he can kind of use the computer if he needs to for work. But other than that, that was pretty much it for the build. I'm just on to the landscaping now, which took me a little bit longer than normal. I didn't do anything fancy, but I've been trying to focus on landscaping a little bit more and spending more time working on the outside of houses. And then this back area, they don't really have a yard, they just have this back deck. And I did put like a barbecue, and I think I put a couple of trees just for some privacy as well. There's no back fence there, so it's pretty much open. And I mean, it wasn't exactly what I wanted. I did want them to have a fenced in yard, but the house was just too big on the lot, so it wasn't really working. And now I'm just trying to decide what should go next to the door. It's so silly. It's just a little plant, but I couldn't decide what I wanted to put there. So I was playing around, finally decided I should put some lights out there because I do think that helps make it look a little bit more realistic. And just some more bushes around the house. I put the garbage can at the back of the deck there. And I think it kind of works out. I mean, they don't have much of a yard, but that's all right. It kind of still works. There is like a little place that the husband can go fishing, which kind of works out nicely. But yeah, that is pretty much it for the build. You can download this house on the gallery. My origin ID is SimQueen1992. If you guys enjoyed this speed build, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Thank you.